Hi guys, and welcome to Tutorial Space with Ola. In this video, we will be talking about the trim tool, which can be seen to be located up here. So far, we have dealt with how to create sketches, but we haven't spoken anything about how to modify them. The trim tool is the most basic tool for modifying our created sketches, and it can be used to create sketches like this, where the parts of the sketch that we do not need are removed from our sketches. So over to the tool. We'll quickly create a sketch here to work with. So with the sketch here created, we go over to the trim tool, which is located here. Now there are five different ways of creating our trims, which you might not see in other 3D modeling softwares. The first of these five ways is the power trim. This is like a wizard kind of trim tool that cuts everything in its parts. So I like to see this as a Pac-Man of trims. So to demonstrate this, I click on my workspace and move my mouse, still holding on my left cursor. Now if you notice that it seems as though I'm creating a path or a trail following my mouse. So it's important for us to know that every point or every sketch entity that this part crosses will be trimmed out, just as you can see here. So this is very similar to the Pac-Man game, so I suppose that this will also be very easy to remember. Okay, so at this point I'll Ctrl+Z and go back to the trim entities. Aside the power trim, we also have the corner trim. Now this trim demands that we select two sketch entities that intersect at a point or a corner, just like this. Now we have this line and this line meeting at this corner, this line and this line meeting at this corner. So I click on my corner trim. And we have to understand that the size of the line we are selecting is going to be the side that will be retained by the software. So if I'm to select this line, you notice I'm selecting the left part of this line with respect to the center. And if I'm to select this line also, now you are able to see a kind of highlight created on these two lines, which is going to retain this part of this line and also this part of this line. Now what about if I choose to select this part of this line here? You notice the bottom part is highlighted while this is highlighted. Okay, so what's really going to happen when I click on this? So for this case, I select on this. We know the parts that are highlighted, and when I click, you know the parts that are retained and the parts that are trimmed away. Okay. That's very simple. And then we go over to the trim away inside. For the trim away inside tool here, we also have a tool that is very similar to this, which is the trim away outside. Now these are very similar to each other, except for the fact that one trims what is outside the selected boundary, while the other trims what is within the selected boundary. So for proper explanation of this, I'll create another sketch just beside this one. Okay, so now that we have the two sketches, we'll go ahead to explain the trim away inside in detail. So what it does is that we have a sketch like this that passes through the boundary of this circle and extends through the other side of the circle up onto this point. So also is the same case for all of these other lines here. So to demonstrate this, we initially have to select our boundary, which in this case is this circle, or it could also be two lines something like a line here and a line here. Boundary doesn't have to be completely closed. All it needs is that the boundary should contain at least two lines where other sketches are passing through. So this is able to work because the lines pass through this part of the circle and also pass through this part of this circle. So we select the boundary, and when this is done, we select on the line we intend to trim. Now please, you should know that wherever we select on the line doesn't matter, whether it be here, the center, or the extreme end here. As you can see, a part of this line is already highlighted, which is the part that is going to be trimmed away, just as the name indicates, trim away inside. If you see also this line, the part to be trimmed away is highlighted, the part to be trimmed away is highlighted. So I select on this, and you see what happens. The tool does the rest. All we need to do is to select on the part of the line to trim. Okay, so now we go over to the trim away outside. And in this case, we'll be using this example. So just as I explained here, we have to select the boundary, which in this case will be two lines, line one and let's say line two. And then the next thing is to select the lines that will be trimmed. So picking on this line right now, you notice the parts of this line that we have shaded. I select on this, and those parts are removed. I select on this, and the parts outside this boundary is what is being deleted. However, it's possible to still delete entities that do not cross through these lines. Or what would happen in that case is that the entire entity would be deleted. So if I selected on this line, you note that the entire line is deleted. If I select on this line, the entire line is deleted. But for the case of trimming away outside, as long as two lines are being crossed, whatever line crosses them, every part of the line outside the boundary would be deleted. So like this again, now we have that. All right, now we have the most commonly used trim tool, which is the trim to closest. Now this requires us to select the exact part of the sketch entity we intend to trim away, just like this. If I choose to trim away this exact part, I click this and it's deleted. If I choose this part, I click this and it's deleted. If I choose this part of this line, I click this and it's deleted. If I choose this, the same. I choose this, the same. I come here, I choose this, the same. So this tool doesn't need us to select a boundary. It just requires us selecting the exact part of the lines or sketch entities to be deleted. Also, now there is a new feature in SolidWorks 2019 where you have the option to convert the entities trimmed into construction geometry rather than just deleting it completely. So if I click on this and I select a particular line to trim, now you notice it has been converted into a construction geometry, and also this converted into a construction geometry, and also this converted into a construction geometry. We have the option of also trimming our construction geometries and not just main lines such as this. Now come over here to trim this construction geometry and click. I've trimmed it, but then it seems as though it still remains. And why is that? That's because the keep trimmed entities as construction geometry is checked. So even though I trimmed it, it's still going to keep it as a construction geometry. So if I uncheck this right now and say trim, now you notice it's being deleted. Trim is also being deleted. And then we could decide not to trim our construction geometries by clicking on this. And then if I come over here, it does not trim. It does not trim. Okay. So this is all you need to know about the trim tool. And I'll see you in the next tutorial where we will treat the opposite of the trim tool together, which is the extend entities.